remember the floating bridge? And the span that went up whenever a ship came and you had to wait for what seemed an eternity waiting for the ship to go through? Those were the days. But now with the Tasman Bridge, of course, no motor vehicles are allowed to be on the bridge while a vessel is passing underneath. You see, we were a gentle time then, and I suppose we took things as they came. But it was a magnificent piece of work, the old floating bridge, and a magnificent piece of memory for us to have a look at tonight, because it takes us back to that time when it was a little more easy going, wasn't it? And no one was really rushing about to get hither and yon. But today, in the way the world is going, then you need to get from point A to point B very quickly. This was the floating bridge, and this is the memory that we have when they were starting to build the Tasman Bridge, bringing the gantries in and moving them into place. The little tugs working hard, getting them all around. Magnificent workmanship.
I remember the night when we walked in the sands of Waikiki and I held you oh so tight.
In many ways, Mother Nature has been benevolent to Tasmania, but when she's put out, she can be a proper harridan. And this storm really, very nearly, destroyed the floating bridge. While the other one was being built, if we hadn't have had it, there was no way to get from one shore to the other. The city would have been definitely cut in halves as the barges bashed and hit during the storm tempest as it came through. It was a trying time for lots and lots of people. It was going to be the time that they would say farewell to the floating bridge. And of course, there had to be that last symbolic cutting of the cord, as it were, as they were taken away for the last time, taken out to sea, to be floated away and then sunk from sight, never to be seen again. It's nice to see it, isn't it? It brings back lots of memories.